Real life, real stories, life lessons with Esther Joseph.
Hi guys, how are you? Welcome back to our YouTube channel. Hope all is well. Remember that I did a video on pray for the weather. Yeah, the Lord did give me some insights of what's going on with this weather. Now, guys, because you've got so many he says, she says, I'm gonna play a clip for you guys to show you that the prophets that know what times and seasons we are in. Yeah, I'm gonna play so you can see the other people saying the same thing about this weather. Now, not everything that you guys see is, you know, is what you're seeing with your eyes. Some things have been triggered, but as I said, I'm gonna show you the video and then you guys take it from there. And the Lord did give me a vision on that, how the technology that these guys have got. So it's up to you guys to be very watchful and to put two and two together. All right, so watch the video guys, be blessed.
Guys, sorry, just to add, yeah, in the vision I saw that everything was just speed, that lights were flashing, and where I live was so like Star Wars, like future, like the technology, everything was like, I don't even know how to explain it. I don't even know how to explain it.
Camberwell Green.
It was like, listen, like a digital, it was just, I don't know how to explain it guys, but the Lord gave me a vision of the technology that they have is out of this world, guys. That human beings, you don't think, unless God gives you the insight, you will not know the technology that these guys have got. So guys, as I said, some of the things that you're seeing, if you don't have the Holy Spirit to give you insight, you just look on the news and think, oh, it's natural, it's this, it's that. No, people of God, the Lord is communicating with us, and it's up to us to listen to your prophets, that you know that the Spirit, the Lord is operating in them, the Holy Spirit, the biblical Holy Spirit of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play the clip so you can have an understanding. He gave me, it was a quick vision, he just gave me a quick vision of the type of technology that they have. It's like it moves mountains, yeah, like it's quick guys, it's quick. Now you can imagine, you've got your phones, so you see what your phones do, so how much more what they have in the, okay? So be blessed guys, I hope I'm helping, you know, because it's really sad to see people being goats, like following everything that the media, the news say. It's sad, it's very sad. But this is not to knock anybody, this is like if you're born again and you're a child of God, disciple, listen up. If you're not, then you're not. What can I say? But anyway, be blessed, and we'll talk soon. God bless you. Adassa.
It's there to protect.
Part today is to share with everybody what is truly going on in the world, because we are watching global famine in the making. We're watching the absolute destruction of the food distribution system, the food growing system, and that ultimately basically results in starvation. The globalists, the Luciferians, and those who want to destroy Christians, they want to depopulate the planet. So, you know, I always want to give people the bottom line, Jim and Lori. I want people to understand that this is not a time for just, oh, well, you know, we'll just wait until Jesus comes. Jesus is coming. But the bottom line is, prior to his coming, and Jim, you know that you've written and talked about this, things are going to get very dicey. So we're watching storms that are being generated by weather weapons. And I want people to understand this. Lyndon Baines Johnson, when he was president, made the statement that he who controls the weather controls the world. I want everybody to hear that again. And this is one of the excerpts and you know, that is on our trailer for Mega Drought. I get so, how should I say, frustrated. That's a good word. That's the nice word. They frustrated when people say, oh, they can't do that. Yes, they can. That they are the people who are in rebellion against God. that have the technology that has been given to them by fallen angels, and one third of the angels in heaven that used to be holy rebelled with Lucifer against the living God. And the understanding they have, the technology, they want one thing. They want the destruction of humanity at all costs. This is conspiracy reality. And the ultimate conspiracy is when Satan himself was able to seduce a third of the angels to follow him in rebellion against God. So the conspiracy word and the theory word was created in 1967 by the Central Intelligence Agency. And it was to basically hide all truth in the cloaking of ridicule. But now we're watching where almost every, quote, conspiracy theory that was out there for the last 20 years is coming into play. And we're watching the most draconian lockdowns in Australia, in some of the Western European nations. And what we're seeing is the loss of freedom and liberty. And I want to make a statement. When you go to a fellowship, when you go to a church, when you go to a congregation, I want you to pay attention to those who speak the name of Jesus, preach in the name of Jesus, and talk to you about Jesus. Because when Jesus is lifted up, the Holy Spirit can convict people of their sin. But unfortunately, Jim, Lori, you know this. Friendship with the world means more to a lot of the, I'll say this, mega ministries than it does their eternal, I should say this, reward in heaven. I want to make this statement because I think it's important.
Yeah.
I think everything we're doing today, I think the storms we're having are indicative of that, is that we're all only one launch command against. We're only one launch command away. They're against us from basically being thrust into eternity. So I think that there needs to be, we're told in scripture, we need to be sober and vigilant. Now, again, in the Cascadia documentary, we pulled out all stops, and I'm going to say this. It's my last documentary. It's not because, you know, obviously they tried to kill me and didn't, and I'm kept alive for a purpose known to God. But the point is that in this film, Mega Drought, and it's available, obviously, from you and all the different deals. But the thing is that it's the most concise presentation of where we are at in the world, in this country. It's condensed, so in just a little bit under an hour, 59 minutes plus, people can see something, and it's a good witnessing tool, but it's a good wake-up call. And many times, you know, even the scripture says we've got to shake ourselves, because as the disciples, even in the garden with Jesus, they fell asleep. And I'm here to tell you, someone who doesn't sleep, I'm going to make sure I wake up everybody with the reality of the hour.
Thank you, and God bless you for watching. Like and subscribe.